Hello everyone, welcome to IndieSec. Today I will teach you, how does a constant pressure system work with a frequency inverter and PLC logo? Let us begin. As you can see, inside the dashboard, we have the PLC logo, a star power drive model inverter, a 24-volt source and a thermal key. Now I will explain the connections of the board. We have the three-phase thermal key, connected to the drive at the inputs, R, S, T, and to the source in, L, N. We also have the source connection, where the positive connects to the L plus of the PLC and the negative connects to the M. Then in the PLC, we have four copper bars connected, each attached to a cable, which send a signal when they come into contact with water, which activates it. These copper bars represent the levels of our water tank for filling and activating the solenoid valve. Where a copper bar was placed at the I5 input, which means the high level. On the I4 it means the middle level. The I3 the low level. Finally, the L plus goes next to the low level of the tank, because the inputs are activated by connecting with the L plus. Then we have a 3-time closed contact selector connected to input I2, I1 and L plus, of which we will only use input I1. On the other hand, at the outputs we have Q1 connected to the solenoid valve, which fills the water, which comes from outside, and at output Q2, the activation of the run of the inverter. On the other hand, in the inverter, the water pump is connected to the U, V, W outputs, and inside the internal card of the inverter, we connect the pressure sensor, which goes from 0 to 10 volts with a pressure of 0 at 60 psi. We connect it to the plus 10V inputs, the positive of the sensor, to GND, the negative, and to AV, the sensor signal. Finally, we connect the Q2 output of the PLC to M0 and GND. Now we are going to lift the thermal key to start the system. Turned on the drive, we will press mode to go to parameters. As you can see, it is in P0. We will go to P1 to activate the operation of output Q2 of the PLC. We will press enter to enter. We see that it is at 0. We will place it in 1 so that it can be commanded, the run of the drive by the PLC. Now we will raise the parameters to P115. We log in and look at the manual. It tells us that P115 is PID set point selection, it is at 0, that is, disabled. We will place it in 1 so we can control it from the drive screen. We press enter. We go up to P116. We enter it in the same way, it is at 0, that is, the reading of our pressure sensor is positive in the PID, but we don't want that, we want it to be negative, so we will set it to 1, since we want the frequency to go up when we have no pressure, we press enter. Now we press mode. We see that the F is at 0. Here we place the pressure on which we want it to be maintained. The water pump we use supports up to 60 Hz. Additionally, our sensor is up to 60 psi, so I want it to remain at 35 psi. So to know what value to set on the variator, we apply a simple rule of 3. Where 60 psi is equivalent to 60 frequency, and we want to know what 35 psi is equivalent to. Multiplying gives us a frequency of 35. We place 35 in F. I tell you this because if you have a pressure sensor that supports more PSI, then you would have to reduce those 35 that I am setting. For example, if my sensor supports up to 100 PSI, and the maximum frequency is 60, and we want 35 PSI. When applying the rule of 3, it gives us a frequency of 21, and that is what we would place if it were the case. Ready, once we understand that, we press mode and we will leave it at H. It is the frequency output of the water pump. Before turning on the PLC, I will explain the program that has to be done. Well, we are now at LOGO Soft, we will start with the programming. We start with the water level inputs, medium, high and low. Which are, I3, is the low level, I4 is the medium level, and I5 is the high level. I'm going to put it in order. We have I3, low level, I4, medium level, I5, high level. We are going to use in gates. We link the three of them, so that when they are in a high state, this sends an activation. We are going to place a relay here, auto latch, and reset. We connect it to the set. We are going to help ourselves with an M1 brand, I connect it here. Now we are going to use the NAND gate, we are going to connect them all in the same way. The I4 and I5. We are also going to place another in gate here, where we connect I1. But here when they are all in the low state, it will make this, be in low, low, and not yet set mark 1, so we are going to deny it here. And this output here, from the NAND gate, we are going to send it here. You already know that the NAND gate, when everything is low state, here it is high state, what it is going to do, make both of them high state, and turn on the Q1 output. Reviewing, we have the low, medium and high level inputs. We link it to a NAND gate, which will latch a mark and set. But since the filling has not started yet, it will be off, this will be in a low state, and it will not latch anything and the mark will be off, but it will we deny, so that the AND gate is in a high state, and here in the NAND, when all of them are in a low state, the output will be in a high state, and so the Q1 output turns on, and now to be able to turn off. Our condition is with another AND gate, we put it in the reset, but our connection is that it has to reset, that is, turn off the Q1 output, when I3 is on, that is, the low level, and the medium level, and high level, are denied, that is, we negate it. That will make it reset, and the low level will never turn off, it will only refill, when the high level is and the medium level is off. This helps you, because it resets it, and starts the process again. This is how the filling function is performed with the solenoid valve, when it is less than the average level. Now we're going to add an AND gate, with I3 the low level, and I4 being the mid level. We connect it to a Q2 output, which would be the run of our inverter, which means that our inverter will always work when the water is above the average level, that is, the low level is on with the average level, and the selector on, which will activate run. Well, that's all, let's simulate it. As you can see, output Q1 is on, which is the solenoid valve. If we turn on the low level, then the medium level, and the high level, it turns off. And if I turned off the high level, it still does not turn on because we have said that when the medium level turns off, it fills again, which means that it never turns off and fills again. It turns on I4, the medium level and the high level, and turns off. On the other hand, if we turn on the selector, it turns on Q2, which is the run of the inverter, we turn it off. Well, I'm going to send all this to the PLC. Ready, now we go into our constant pressure system. We will turn on the PLC. And we will see that our water tank begins to fill, since all three levels are off. The low level has already been activated. Now the middle level. Thank you. Finally, the high level. The solenoid valve turns off. Now that the tank is full, we will activate the selector. We can see that when we activate the frequency, it begins to quickly rise to its maximum. And the pressure normally, until it approaches or is equal to 35 psi, the frequency begins to drop to 0 Hz, and the pressure remains at 35 psi. Now we are going to move the pipe so that water comes out. We see that the pressure begins to oscillate between 29 or 33 psi. Now we will see that the tank is decreasing, but the solenoid valve is still off. We wait for it to pass below the medium level, and we see that it begins to fill the water until it reaches the high level. Now we see the pressure continues to oscillate. This causes the variator to also oscillate its frequency through the pressure sensor. Now we will close the pipe. Without water, we see the pressure begin to rise to 35 psi, and the inverter frequency to drop to 0 Hz. Finally, we observed that the solenoid valve reached the high level and stopped filling water. Finally, we will deactivate the selector. Well, I hope you liked the video, and don't forget to subscribe to the channel and leave your like. Thanks for watching, until next time.